Hi, everyone. Merry Christmas from the Children's Ministry. We are just so excited to celebrate the birth of Jesus with you all today. And regardless of where you're at in your relationship with God, everyone's kind of heard some form of the story of Jesus's birth or seen a nativity scene. And it's become so familiar that sometimes we forget how special it really is. And so we just wanted to present the story in a fun and a fresh way that some of the kids here at Cornerstone with some adult help. And we just hope that through it, we all just remember how special and really epic the birth of Jesus really was. So hand it over to Tim.
Okay. You hear me? Okay, good. So Pastor Anton asked Ann and I to put on a skit, but you know Anton, right? He told us like yesterday. And we've only had like a day to prepare. He gave me this script and I can barely even like read his handwriting here. And so I'm going to need some help from both you guys and from everybody. So we need everyone from the audience. We need some volunteers for actors because it's all very last minute here. So first role is we need a, this is our main character today. We need a little girl who is, the script here says, highly favored with God. Very cute girl. Does anyone volunteer want to play? We have Anne. Okay, come on. Okay, hold on. Okay, so what's your name?
You already know mine.
Oh, this is Malia. But today, we're going to call you Mary. So can you put on our Mary costume? Yeah, I'll let you handle that. And good. This is very complicated. And you get this cute little veil and this thing comes around in the back. All right, now come here so everyone can see you. So this is where we need our audience participation. So what do we say when we see a very pretty young girl? We say, ah. Everyone, come on. One, two, three, ah. Okay, stand off on the side and we'll cast the other roles. Okay, so now we need a little boy who works really hard. We have any volunteers to play? Micah, come up here. This is Micah. Micah, this is Micah, but today you are going to be Joseph. Here, put this on. And Joseph. Yeah, let's all clap for Joseph. Okay, wait. Up. And, so Joseph was a man of God. He worked very hard. And, you know, carpenters have beards. So, let's put a beard on Joseph. All right, thank you. Okay, so stand over there. We'll cast the other roles. All right, now we need a chorus of angels. We have some girls. We need some angels. And who? Kira? Who else? Who else wants to be an angel? JC? Who, any other angels? There's an angel right here. Abby, come on. Look, you're already in costume. Come on. So we have, that's an incredible coincidence. So now we have our angels. Let's see, what are your names?
My name is Kira.
This is Kira.
JC.
JC.
Abby.
Abby. And?
Claire.
Claire. All right, Kira, you're going to be our main angel. So why don't you stand up here? Because when angels appear, stand up here on this chair. So here's your halo. Hold up above your head like this. Okay, here's your. Oh, you guys, your is much better than mine. All right. So when, you know, when angels appear, there's a sound, right? So let's hear, let's have everyone go, okay. This is going to happen a number of times, so I need you to all be more into it when they come on. Okay. Okay, thank you. Okay, go off to the side and let's cast the next, all right, we need three smart guys. Or guys, girls, anyone who's... James, come on up. Okay, we have James and Elias. Do we have another one? Anyone else want to go? We can go with two, but we could use a third one. Over there. Anybody want? Okay, we'll go with two. Oh, how about back there? Come up. So what, James, Elias, and... Okay, so... The only thing you have to be for this role is you got to be smart. You're our wise men, right? What grade are you in? Oh, where's our mic? I lost it. What grade are you in? Kindergarten. Second grade. What grade are you? Oh, what's your name?
Bison.
And what grade are you in? Oh, here's the mic. Okay. Well, you know, you guys are probably pretty good at math, right?
Of course.
Yes. Good. But I need, you know, you guys are going to come on in about like 5 minutes, so you need to get a little bit wiser by then, right? So I got some books for you here. This is, how about you get Calculus 2, you get Calculus 3, you get Law and Economics, all right? Now, I need you guys to go off to the side and study. By the time you get up here. Oh, okay, sorry, you might not know what these are. These are books. So they're kind of like an iPad, except that the screens don't change. And to switch, you have to flip the pages, okay? But amazingly enough, these cost about as much as iPads. Okay. So when you guys are gonna get a lot of ideas today, right? When you guys get an idea, I want you to hold the book above your head. Hold the book above your head. And say, and everyone in the audience says, Eureka!
Eureka!
Eureka! Yeah, okay, that's good. That's much better, you guys. Okay, all right, off to the side. Study those up. Oh, to the side. Okay, let's see, where are we? Nick's. We need three kids who like animals. Who do we have? Volunteers? Shepherds, sure. You got one here? Faith? Nelson? Okay, that's good. Three. All right. You already have a little lamb. Okay, but so shepherds need their sheep. So, you guys get this one. All right. Okay. Oh, yeah. You get the two small ones. Okay. So these are our shepherds. And so what sound does a sheep make? Baa. Okay. All right. You guys will come on later. Step off to the side. Now our last role, we're gonna need an adult to help us out here. Do we have maybe someone's dad or a pastor that might want to volunteer? Anybody? Okay, here, he's standing up. Come on up. This is here. Put this on. This is what's your name? This is Pastor Dwayne, and he is going to be Herod. And Herod, he was. He was, you know, he had really wrinkly skin, a scraggly beard, a little bit of a humpback. No one liked him. He's really evil. Hey, don't try so hard. You're a natural at this. And he was king. He was the king of the Jews then. Here's his crown. And you get a sword because evil people have swords. Can you give me a... Let's see, where's our mic? Can you give me a big, you know, arr? I don't know. Yeah! Okay, so what do we do for bad guys? We boo them, right? Can we boo him? Boo!
Ah!
Boo! This is like your one chance to boo your pastor. Until Pastor Joe comes on later. Okay, so let's get started with our story. Let's get started. Let's get Mary and Joseph, come up here. All right, so once upon a time, there was a boy named Joseph and a girl named Mary. And they were very much in love, and they were engaged to be married. But they weren't married yet, so you guys have to separate. Okay, so let's do Mary first. Mary, come here. And she was standing right here. Let's say, ah, yeah, thank you. You guys got the prompt. Okay, and all of a sudden, an angel appeared here. And she said, greetings, you who are highly favored.
Greetings, you are highly favored.
Could put a little more emotion. Okay. And Mary, she was so scared. Give me your best, like, Home Alone. That might be, just scream really loud. Over here, just scream really loud. And she was scared. And the angel said, don't be scared.
Don't be scared.
Don't be scared. God will give you a baby.
God will give you a baby.
And you are to give him the name Jesus.
And you are to give him the name Jesus.
He will be the Son of God.
He will be the Son of God.
And then the Holy Spirit came and put a baby inside Mary. You put that in your tummy. Okay, go off to the side. And then, let's bring Joseph in here. Now, Joseph, you just found out your fiance is pregnant. You'd probably do what I did, just go like this. No, like this. Okay, anyway, okay. And then, you know, so he was a little bit worried that his fiance was pregnant, so he took a nap. And then all of a sudden an angel appeared. And Joseph was also scared. That's what we're looking for. And the angel said, Mary has a baby from God.
Mary has a baby from God.
It's okay for you to marry her.
It's okay to marry her.
And take care of the baby.
And take care of the baby.
Okay, thank you. So that Joseph, he wasn't worried anymore, and he went off to marry Mary. Mary, come back up. And so they had a wedding. They had a wedding. Do you take Joseph? Yes, I do.
Yes.
Yes. Do you take Mary?
Yes.
And now I pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Okay, you may now hold hands with the bride. Well, they were very much, you know, in a couple of years when you want to ask her to prom, this is going to be awkward. Okay, but anyway, they got married. And let's see, what's next? So the Emperor of Rome at that time, we don't have Emperor of Rome, so I'll be him. The Emperor of Rome said, there will be a census. And everyone needs to go home and be counted. And Joseph and Mary, well, Joseph, they lived in Nazareth. But Joseph was from Bethlehem. So they had to walk all the way from Bethlehem, oh no, from Nazareth to Bethlehem. So you guys just walk. Wait, okay. So have you ever been pregnant before? So you're 9 months pregnant. You don't walk like that. It's like this. You put your hand like this. Okay? And Joseph, your wife is 9 months pregnant. You walk around like this. Okay? Hands on your ears. That's how we're. Okay, now let's walk. Like this. Okay, this is a long way from Bethlehem or Nazareth to Bethlehem. So let's speed this up. Let's travel by map. There. We're at Bethlehem. Ta-da! It's a miracle. Okay. When they got to Bethlehem, Joseph wanted to find room in the inn. So he asked everybody, "Do you have room?"
"Do you have room?"
And everybody said, "No." Maybe if you said please.
Please.
But everyone said, "No." Oh, okay. So all they could do was find a place in a manger. Mary sits down for you. Okay. And so they were in a manger. Now, a manger, if you don't know, is a place where animals live. So we don't have any. Can someone bring up an animal so we can have an animal up here? Owen's getting the animal. Sure, whatever you got. Owen. This is an elephant. Okay. Well, so there was an elephant. Okay, now you just wait here. And we're going to get you other guys into the skit. All right, shepherds, come up here. Get the There can be boy and girl shepherds. It's okay. All right. So the shepherds were a little bit outside Bethlehem, and they were taking care of their sheep. When all of a sudden, an angel appeared. A whole host of angels appeared. Okay, and all the shepherds, they were scared. And one of the host of angels said, "Glory to God.
Glory to God.
And goodwill to men.
Goodwill to men.
And peace on earth.
Peace on earth."
And then the shepherds were still scared. And the main angel said, "Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Today a Savior is born.
Today a Savior is born.
He is the Christ the Lord.
He is the Christ the Lord."
Okay, thank you. And then the angels disappeared. Then the shepherds, they got an idea. They said, "Why don't we go and see the Savior?
How we go and see the Savior?"
Okay, so then they began to walk. Walk. Wait, keep your sheep. They begin to walk. And they walk really far. Just follow me. I bet this is a lot of walking, huh? You'd probably like to travel by map too, right? But wait. Cut. So I've been told that there's no budget for that special effect again. You know, next time when your parents, you know, when they put some money in the offering, maybe you can ask them to put a little more in, okay? Okay. Okay, so you guys just walk in a circle over here.
Okay.
Now, okay. Now, back to Mary and Joseph. These guys are expecting a Savior when they get here. So you're going to need to push, Mary. Can you push? Okay, no. Push that baby out of you. Or just take it out. Okay. There, the Savior is born. That was pretty easy, huh? Is your mom out there? Make sure you say you love you to your mom every day. It's not going to be that easy. Say I love you to your mom anyway. Okay. Oh, all these shepherds. And then all of a sudden, the shepherds arrived. And they were able to see the baby Jesus. Come visit the baby Jesus. They were so excited, they went and they told They told everybody about Jesus being born. Yay, so run around all the way over there. And then the shepherds left. Then, shepherds over here. Okay. Then there was a star in the sky. And where are wise men? Wise men. And the wise men followed the star. Follow the star. And they had an idea. Hold up your book. Eureka! They said, let's go ask the king of the Jews.
Let's go ask the king of the Jews.
So they went to go ask the king of the Jews where the Messiah was. Boo! And so they asked, do you know where Jesus is?
You know where Jesus is?
And of course, Herod didn't know.
No.
Didn't know. But Herod said, when you find him.
When you find him.
Tell me so I can worship him too.
Tell me so I can go worship him too.
And so the wise men did it. They followed. They kept on following the star. But Herod, he was sneaky. And he had lied to the wise men. He didn't want to worship Jesus. He wanted to kill him. Boo. Boo. So, that's it for Herod. So then the wise men walked all the way to Bethlehem. And they visited Mary and Joseph and gave them gifts. Gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. When they were about to go and go back and tell Herod where Jesus was, when suddenly an angel appeared again. And the angel said, Herod is trying to kill Jesus.
Herod is trying to kill Jesus.
And the wise men had an idea. Eureka! And they decided that they would go home a different route. Say, we'll go home.
We'll go home.
And then they went home a different route. This way. And Joseph said, we'll go to Egypt.
We'll go to Egypt.
And so Joseph went to Egypt. When Herod realized the wise men had tricked him, he was furious! And he arrived in Bethlehem! But they are already gone! They are in Egypt! And so he couldn't kill Jesus. So he went back home. Over here. And so let's fast forward. Let's fast forward a couple years. Come on, over here. We'll fast forward a couple years. And Herod eventually died. And let's see. The script in the Bible doesn't say how he died. So let's ask the audience. Did he die peacefully in his sleep or from the mystery liquid? And Herod died. And then it was safe for Mary and Joseph to come back, and Mary, Joseph, and Jesus, where they raised Jesus to be the next Messiah and Savior, and we continue that later. And that's, come here. And that's the first story of Christmas. Yay! Let's bring all the kids up. Does everyone come up? All right, let's take a everyone up. Let's take a bow. Yeah. Thank you guys for all coming. Okay. We also just want to make sure that, you know, we took a couple of creative liberties in the story here today. But, you know, when you guys get home, this is all from the Bible. So if you want to read, like, the first couple chapters of Luke, the first couple chapters of Matthew, and you can really see what the Bible says and know what's true. So when you go home tonight, maybe use this as an opportunity to read to your kids the first couple chapters of Luke, first couple chapters of Matthew. And, so let's give another round of applause for our volunteers. And Auntie Anne has gifts for you over there. Okay. If you have costumes, go off to the side and give them to Auntie Anne and Auntie Owen. And, okay,